Morning Indians, I'm Zayla Coleman.
And I'm Gigi Macklin.
Okay Gigi, let's get started with our announcements.
Next week, everyone will be coming to school Monday and Tuesday. The students that will be taking the EOCs will come to school December 9th through the 15th, while everyone else will be doing virtual learning at home. We will come back the 16th through the 18th, and that Friday is a half day. And you can always find this info in Infinite Campus.
With the colder weather rolling in, it is important to protect your pets. Now, we turn to Kylie Stedman for some tips on this week's Pet of the Week.
Today, we are here with Miss Gloria. She's about 8 years old. And she's an owner surrender, and she is up for adoption, and she's looking for a really, really good home.
And with the cold temperatures, it's important to keep your pets safe and warm. A great idea is to provide blankets for them. Dog sweaters are a great idea for your dog if they will wear one, and checking on them more frequently. I am Kylie Stedman with Pet of the Week.
Thanks, Kylie. That was great. Now here's a few students with some holiday treats.
Hey, I'm Kate.
And I'm Michaela, and today we're going to show you how to make an easy, fun Christmas tree. The ingredients are mini Twix, mini pretzels, and mini M&Ms.
So we already got our stuff unwrapped and ready, but what you're going to do now is take your Twix and microwave it for about 10 seconds so that it'll become soft and you can add your decorations. So we have two brown M&Ms for the eyes, and we're just going to put those up at the top. And then the red M&M is for the nose. And then after you've done that, you're going to take your two pretzels and put them at the top of the nose.
Now we've made our cute little reindeer.
Yeah, guys, why don't y'all come try them?
Our 2020 football season is over, and we will be focusing in on our winter sports.
But first, let's get a recap on our pep rally and a football game from Madeline Austin.
I'm here at the reservation for this year's first pep rally. The competition cheerleaders are going to show us the
Levi!
I'm with Marley G, bro, flying Holly Grove chicks to my Hollywood shows. And I wanna tell you something that you probably should know. This that Slumdog Millionaire Bollywood flow. And my real friends never hearing from me. Fake friends write the wrong answers on the mirror for me. That's why I pick and choose. I don't get you confused. I got a small circle, I'm not with different crews. We walk the same path, but got on different shoes. Live in the same building, but we got different views. I got a couple cars, I never get to you on the pole. Plus I've been sipping, so this shit is moving.
I'm here at the reservation for the Indians' final game of the season. We take on East Jackson in just an hour. Tonight is also senior night. Soon our seniors, including myself, will be lining up on the track to be recognized. Let's see how this game turns out. The Indians' final game was a great one. They came out strong and maintained their momentum. From all aspects and every angle, the Indians had East Jackson locked down. Our boys showed us what a great team looks like. Every great team starts with a great quarterback. Ben Stowe's versatility shined bright last Friday. Whether it's getting the ball out or taking the run when need be, Stowe made the play happen.
I feel great. I mean, put 61 up on them. And it was a great feeling.
A great quarterback isn't complete without his receivers. Last Friday, just like the rest of the season, Gamarion and Kenny completed pass after pass, putting points on the board. Our running backs reminded us that they are unstoppable. Zach Feaster and Corey Ibrahim have been impressing us since the beginning of the season. As much praise as we can give the offense, it would all be nothing if they didn't have our immovable defense behind them. From our strong line, diligent DBs, and persistent aggression, the Indians are dependent on their defense. 2020's final game, 61-16 Indians.
21 out.
Hey, 21 in, 21 out.
Hey, 5-0 out, baby.
Coming off of senior night, I'm here with a senior and a rising senior to ask a few questions about this year's football season.
You're a rising senior. How are you feeling with this upcoming responsibility?
Yeah, I think it's a big part of coming up and being a senior, taking on the part of trying to be, you know what I'm saying, like a captain or something, or like taking on a big part on the team.
Are you excited for next season?
Very, very excited.
What have you learned from this season that you're planning on taking with you next season?
Don't take anything for granted because it can go by in the blink of an eye.
Yeah, just like some of your seniors.
Yeah.
Alrighty. What are you looking forward to this next chapter?
Really, next chapter of life. I'm just looking forward to finding my future, you know, continuing with football at the next level, you know, continue to get better, you know, maybe one day come back and give back to the community.
What's something from this season you want to carry into next season with you?
The hard work, perseverance. Like Coach Chank say, attack today. We got to attack every day like it's the last. Never know when it's going to be the last, so you got to attack.
That's very true. KP, this was a weird season all around. Do you feel like you missed out on anything going through COVID and football?
Missed out on a lot.
Yeah?
A lot.
Like what?
Missed a few games because of Corona, but if it wasn't here, be sure that we'd be going to the playoffs if Corona would have never hit.
Alrighty. Well, we had a great season. Thank y'all for coming.
For sure.
Basketball played Raven County on Tuesday. The boys won, but unfortunately, the girls did not come out on top. Our boys are 1-2, while our girls are 2-1. The next basketball game is tonight at 5:30. Come out and show your support. Also on Tuesday, our wrestling team had a dual tournament. They beat Habersham for the first time in 20 years. Their next tournament will be tomorrow at 8 a.m. against Jackson County. Back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Madeline. In Ms. Hanksley's class, we have been producing public service announcements. One of the students, Chris Gore, used her art skills along with this class and drew and illustrated her PSA.
She used Procreate and Adobe editing software. The results were amazing and communicate a powerful message about mental health.
Let's take a look at that now. Don't forget to have a great weekend.